Chantal, and I will explain to you how we make cheese here. Behind me and on the side, you can also see the explanation in a short way in different languages, for instance, Portuguese and Italian. I first tell you something about Holland. We have about 16 million people and about 4 million cows. That means there's one cow for every 4 people. And we need those cows because the average Dutchman eats 21 kilos of cheese every year. The process of cheese making starts when the farmer brings in the fresh milk every morning. He brings it to the container and then we take it into the machine where we heat the milk up till 30 degrees centigrade. This temperature is very important for this liquid called rennet. Rennet is a natural enzyme which causes the milk to curdle. After 30 minutes in the machine, the milk gets thick, like a pudding, and we start cutting it using these special rotating knives. These knives will separate the milk into two parts, a liquid part and a solid part. The liquid part is called whey and the solid part is called curds. The curds are becoming the cheese. But the whey is actually very healthy. It's full of vitamins and proteins. That's why we feed this back to the animals. But because it's so healthy and really good for your skin, they say, you can also drink it yourself. So I started drinking it every morning, one glass of the whey. And now you may guess how old I am.
35.
20? Thank you. 35? No, actually, I'm 74. The good stuff. We're going to push the curds into the mold, together with a special stamp on the bottom, which tells us what kind of cheese it is. And then the molds go underneath the pressing machine for a couple hours. We now can take the cheeses out and we move the cheeses into the salt bed. We keep them in the salt bed for 24 hours. Gives them a better taste and a natural rind. After that, we start plastifying the cheeses to protect them against mildew and drying out. We now move them up to the shelves and after 4 weeks, it's a young cheese. After 4 months, it's slightly matured and after 8 months, we call it the old cheese. Upstairs, we have this very special old cheese, because this one actually is 3 years old. Another special cheese we have is this one. It looks like a sausage, but it is cheese. Smoked cheese, like we smoke ham or fish. And we have this made from goat and cow milk. So please, I need an assistant. Is there anybody who would like to try some cheese? Please.
Shocker.
Hey, you're wearing the same shoes. Do you please hold this up? In Holland, we like to eat cheese on our bread, and we use this special knife to create perfect slices that we can put on the bread. Would you like to try? Maybe he wants to try as well? Perfect. Thank you. Is there anybody else who would like to try some cheese? Please? Nobody? Sir, please, come on. Hi there. If you can stand next to me, please, and put your hands together. Because another knife that we use is the funny knife called the grater. And we use this one for cheese on our spaghetti. Our baby on macaroni, our some lasagna, our tacos. Ahora en español? Hey, en español. Spaghetti, macaroni, pizza! Italiano? No, Italiano?
Sí, sí,
Italiano. Macaroni, pasta, pizza, and in Holland, on the pancakes. Enjoy your lunch. boat, which you can try with a little piece of cheese. All the cheeses are either waxed or vacuumed, which you can keep them out of the refrigerator up to 4 weeks. So you can travel around with the cheese and keep them on room temperature. In the refrigerator, you can keep them for up to 4 to 6 months. I now would like to invite you to go upstairs where you can try all the different kinds of cheese. Thank you very much for your attention and have a very nice day.
Thank you.